Okay, we'll do the first example here of exercising Floyd's algorithm to find all shortest paths between pairs. All pairs shortest path, right? So let's just exercise the algorithm right here. Okay, I'm going to start with K1, I1, and then J1. And what we're going to do at each step through here is I'm going to look for the current shortest path from I to J by passing through K. And then I will update the matrix, my W matrix, using this code right here. And if you look at this code right here, what I'm actually computing here is the minimum of the path from I to J, so we call that G dot W I J, or the path from I to K plus the path from K to J, so that is using K, so G dot W I K plus G dot W K J. So whichever, so either the updated minimum will either be the current minimum that I have before I go into this innermost loop right here, or it will be the an improved minimum by considering how K helps shorten the path. Okay, let's go ahead and start to execute this on this picture right here. And so I will be building my W1, which we getting built on top of this thing right here. So I'm just going to start it right here, W1. And A, B, C, D. Okay. Okay, so here we have that our K is stepping 1 through the number of vertices, I is stepping 1 through the number of vertices, and J is going 1 through the number of vertices. I'm just going to use A, B, C, D rather than 1, 2, 3, 4, just to make my life easier. A, B, C, D will be the order I'm taking them in, okay? I don't know why we didn't do that in the first place. Pseudocode certainly allows that, no problem. Okay, so I start out with K is A, and I is A, and J is A, and I'm looking to see, I'm looking to compute a new possible shortest path from A to A by using A. Okay, so here I'm looking at my A to A by using the A. So I say the new shortest path will be the minimum between that is the minimum of the current weight from A to A, which is infinity, or the current weight from A to A, which is infinity, plus the weight from A to A, which is infinity. So there's been no improvement right there. We just copied that down. Okay, so my J next goes to B, and now I'm looking for my new minimum right here by passing through A. So this will all go pretty fast because I and K are the same thing, but I'll just step through it really fast. Okay, so I'm looking to find here the minimum between the current going from A to B, is 3, or A to A is infinity. Actually, we should be using this A to A here. A to A plus plus the cost from A to B right here, so that's 3, no change. B, J goes to C, so I look for the minimum between A and C, which is 1, and A to A, which is infinity, plus A to C, which is 1, so the minimum of 1 and infinity is 1. No change there. Okay, then J goes to D, so I look to find the cost from A to D is infinity. The cost from A to A is infinity, plus the cost from A to D is infinity. No change there. Okay, so we then have, let's change colors here. I goes to B, and J is A. So going through my J loop now, I have the minimum from B to A. B to A is infinity, or B to A, which is infinity, plus A to A, which is infinity. B to A is infinity, A to A is infinity, so that's no improvement right there. J is B, so now I'm looking to find the minimum between B and B, or B and A to B. B to B is infinity, B to A is infinity, A to B is 3. So that's a bunch of infinity, so there's no improvement there. Let's pause for a minute right here and see what we figured out. We're trying to figure out what is the shortest path from B to B, okay? And the shortest path from B to B, there's no path from B to B, right? There's no path from B to B. But one possible path to consider is if there exists a path from B to A and then A back to B. Well, the path from B to A is infinity, and the path from A back to B is 3. So infinity plus 3 gives me infinity. Compared to B, that's infinity. That's why I have this infinity right here. Okay. Step my J to my next one to C. So now I'm looking to find the minimum between B and C. B to C is 1. Or B to A. B to A is infinity, so I could just stop there. We stop at 1, okay? Next is D. I'm looking for the path to find the minimum between B and D. B and D. B to D is 2 versus B to A. B to A is infinity plus A to D. A to D is infinity. So 2 versus infinity gives us 2. So I goes to C, and I start with J is A. Okay, so now I'm looking to find the minimum from C to A. C to A is infinity, or C to A, which is infinity, plus A to A, which is infinity. So no joy there. Okay, so now I'm looking to update the CB, which is right here. CB is infinity versus CB, versus CA. CA is infinity, and then AB. AB is 3, so that's infinity. No help there. Okay, J is C, so now I'm looking for this new distance right here. C is infinity versus CA. CA is infinity plus AC. AC is 1. So that gives me infinity there. Okay. Update my J. So I've got IJ is CD. So CD is 4. So it's 4 versus CA. CA is infinity, and AD is infinity. So 4 is definitely better than a couple infinities. Okay. Okay, so we now have I is D, and I'm going to start my J at A. So now I'm looking D to A. It'll be the minimum from D to A. D to A is 1. Versus D to A, which is 1, plus A to A, which is infinity. 1 versus 1 plus infinity gives us 1. Let me pause for a minute and take a look at that. That's saying the path from D to A, either directly or by way of A, is 1, which is what I have here. Okay, let's go J equals B. So now I'm looking for D to B right here. D to B is infinity. D to B directly is infinity. There's nothing there. Or I can go by way of A, which will be 1 plus 3. So the minimum of 1 plus 3 in infinity gives us 4. Okay, so let's pause for a minute, take a look at that. This is telling us the cost of the shortest path from D to B found so far by way of A for my W1, K equals A, by way of A for my W1 is 4. So D to B directly, path is infinity, by way of A is 1 plus 3 gives me 4. All right, let's continue then. Update the J to C. So now I'm looking DC, which is this point right here. You can look at the graph and tell us what we're going to have to end up with. The path directly from D to C is infinity. The path from D to C by way of A is 1 plus 1 gives me 2. So I should end up with a 2 right there. Okay, so it is the minimum of from D to C. D to C is infinity, or D to A. D to A is 1, see the 1, plus A to C. A to C is 1. 1 plus 1 gives me 2. That's what I expect. Okay, this goes to D, J goes to D, and now I'm looking for this point right here. So D to D is infinity, and then D to A is 1 plus A to D. A to D is infinity, so that's still infinity. So let's pause for a minute, look at our graph. That's saying D to D direct has a cost of infinity, or I can go by way of A, which is 1, plus there is no path from A to D, so that's infinity.